And you're watching CNT News. Thanks for joining us. Hello, I'm Lucas McFadden.
Good evening. I'm Renee O'Neill. Laura Bree will join us a little later in the show. First up tonight, a major battery spill on Interstate 77.
And we are talking thousands of batteries scattered all over the interstate and the shoulder there of I-77 in York County and Fort Mill. CN2's Alexandria Savage catching up with those commuters who are caught in traffic.
There's a semi sitting on top of the concrete barrier in the middle, and the whole side of it split open.
According to the Flint Hill Volunteer Fire Department, the driver of the tractor trailer lost control and landed on top of the median riding the wall for about 20 to 40 feet. The side of the trailer split open, releasing tens of thousands of AA batteries everywhere.
Chaos.
The driver was not injured. The accident occurred just after 8 a.m. Three people were injured by debris heading down the southbound lane. They were transported to CMC. Kevin Collins didn't see the incident happen, but he passed the cleanup. He says the traffic was unreal.
We've been an hour sitting in traffic. It's back clear up to past Tiga K.
Collins and his wife were traveling north when they got stuck in the traffic from the accident.
We were about at mile marker 56 or something. There's an exit down there. And it's been 2 hours to get here.
Sandra Sheen was headed south on I-77, leaving Charlotte, and she says traffic was at a standstill on that side of the interstate as well.
I finally had to get off the road because it was eating up my gas, and there seemed to be no end to the line of traffic.
South Carolina Department of Transportation was out there responding to the situation as well.
I could see the gas tank just dropping, and I said, I cannot do this anymore. I have to get off.
According to Flint Hill first responders, the truck was removed at about 1:30 Wednesday afternoon, but batteries were still being cleaned up when they left closer to 2 o'clock. In Fort Mill, Alexandria Savage, CN2 News.
According to the Flint Hill Volunteer Fire Department, the repairs on the median may take a little longer. They say the damage was excessive.